Hello, welcome. We are looking at the lab diagnosis for tania. We will look at the lab diagnosis for taniasis and cysticercosis separately. Okay. First of all, let's take a quick recap. A quick recap of what we have seen so far. Helminth cestode intestinal, beef tapeworm, pork tapeworm, the life cycle, the pathogenesis, the pathogenicity. Then we saw the clinical features of cysticercosis. Then we saw the places where and all it's affecting, neurocysticercosis, ocular cysticercosis, ICSOL, intracranial space occupying lesion. Now we have come to lab diagnosis. Okay. Now lab diagnosis, we will look at taniasis, how intestinal taniasis, how you will detect. Obviously stool examination, what and all you will see in the stool, you can try to look for the eggs, the proglottids, the scolex. Then you can also look at the antigen. Okay, you can try to detect the antigen in the feces. Hold on, let us look at the egg. Hold on. This is how the egg looks, correct? For tania. And in fact, you cannot distinguish between the tania saginata and the tania solium. You cannot distinguish the egg. Proglottids, other reproductive structures, you can try to detect them. Scolex, you can see here how they look like. For tania saginata, tania solium has the two pairs of, two rows of hooklets, rostellum, etc. So you can also detect the antigen in the feces. Serodiagnosis usually is for antibody, correct? So let us look at the details of these, okay? Eggs. Microscopic examination of feces, they show the characteristic eggs of tania in most of the patients. Either you can use formal ether sedimentation method, that is useful. So for stool concentration, right? Stool concentration, you will use stool concentration method. You can use formal ether sedimentation method, etc. There are so many methods, okay. I think these are more like fillers they are adding. It's all very generic stuff. Okay. So eggs can also be detected by cellophane swab method. So you can also do by cellophane stab method, microscopic examination, or you can do cellophane swab method. Swab method, that is NIH swab. In most patients, this also you can detect. What is the cellophane swab method? Do you know what it is? So NIH is actually National Institute of Health USA. Here what you will do, they have a swab or cellophane swab, okay. So basically they take the cellophane tape, normal cellophane tape, okay. Then they will, on the perianal area, right, they will swab it, cellophane tape. So the cellophane tape, that gum, right, that whatever is left out, right, that stools, they will stick there, especially for animals and all, it's very useful. So you can put it to that perianal part, and that cellophane tape, you stick it and remove it, you'll get some material, right, that you will examine. So in that you can detect the eggs. So that is cellophane swab map, cellophane swab, swab method, okay. So let's move on now. Okay, so where are we now? We have detected the eggs, right? By microscopy, the cellophane safe swab. You cannot identify the species because saginata, solium, both are similar, correct? That you know, right? Should we write that here? So eggs of tania saginata and tania solium are similar. So you cannot distinguish, okay? Now coming to proglottids. So proglottids, the species identification you can do, you can use a hand lens, okay? And the gravid proglottid, you can, it is pressed between two slides. So if you examine the gravid proglottid, there will be lateral branches on the tania saginata, okay? There will be lot of branches in tania saginata. So tania saginata shows more, right? Shows more proglottids that you have already seen. And in solium, tania solium, it will be little less. Okay. Then moving on to scolex. Scolex, basically, this Tinea saginata, it is not having those hooklets, rostellum. Here you have the rostellum with two rows of hooklets. So basically it is armed. Tinea solium is armed, correct? Then, moving on to the detection of Tinea antigen and feces. So basically using ELISA, you can detect the antigen. Okay. You can use polyclonal antisera against Tinea, which you already get, I think. So you will detect the copro antigen in feces. Okay. This is actually more sensitive than microscopy. Right? But you cannot differentiate between Tinea saginata and Tinea solium. Okay. So you detect, you use this polyclonal antisera. Okay. And you try to detect this copro antigen you will try to detect. Okay. Cannot differentiate. I think it's too small and you're not able to see, right? Cannot differentiate Tinea saginata and Tinea solium. If they could differentiate, they would have told us what the differentiating features are. So we are done with the stool concentration now. So now let us move on to serodiagnosis. Okay. Now we are moving to serodiagnosis for intestinal teniasis. Now serodiagnosis, antibodies only you will detect, correct? By ELISA again. ELISA, but detect antibodies. Okay. You can use indirect immunofluorescent test. IIFT or IFT? Indirect immuno FLUORESCENCE fluorescence test, and you can also use indirect heme agglutination test. Okay. Now we are moving on to molecular diagnosis. Definitely what you will write here. So easy, right? You will use PCR, polymerase chain reaction, to detect and differentiate between the eggs and phlogglottids of Tinea saginata and Tinea solium. You can also distinguish the subspecies, it seems. Subspecies, I don't even know the names. Okay. So you can use PCR, DNA probes, etc. to detect the, you can also differentiate between the, can differentiate between Tinea saginata and Tinea solium. Okay. So we are done with the lab diagnosis of intestinal teniasis. How many people understood? How many people are sleeping? Shall we move on to the lab diagnosis of cysticercosis? Shall we move on in this video only? Otherwise, we have to make one more video. Lab diagnosis of cysticercosis. Quickly, let us look at. So basically, biopsy, right? Biopsy, they will do of the lesion, subcutaneous lesion and all, you've heard, right? Muscle, everything. So biopsy of the lesion you can do, and you can do biopsy of lesion, microscopic exam. What you will see? You will see scolex, right? It is scolex with the suckers and hooks. Hooks means for solium. Solium only causes cysticercosis. So obviously hooks should be there, right? Should have scolex with hooks, correct? So done with biopsy already. Next, moving on. Imaging methods, you can do X-ray. Calcified cysticerci you can detect by radiography. So basically you know that it will cause calcification, fibrosis, and finally larva itself will die in that place. So basically in X-ray you will see calcified cysticerci, okay, of subcutaneous tissue, muscles, buttocks, thigh. X-ray of skull also can demonstrate cerebral calcified cyst. So basically you can see calcified cysticerci, okay. Then computed tomography, CT scan. So CT scan of brain is best method for detecting dead calcified cysts. So it is best method they are saying. So remember here, best method for detecting brain, scan of brain is best method for detecting dead calcified cysts. Okay. The cysticercal lesions, they appear as small hypodensities, ring-like or disc-like they will be with bright central spot. Guys, this you have to learn and understand what they are saying. The cysticercal lesions appear as small hypodensities with bright central spot. The cysticercal lesions appear as small hypodensities, ring or disc-like with bright central spot. Can you really see that here? Bright central spots. These are calcified. That's why they are white, right? What are we talking about? Cysticercal lesions. This is the cysticercal lesion, right? Maybe. Okay. Then moving on. Magnetic resonance imaging MRI scan you can do of the brain. So this is also helpful. And you can detect non-calcified cyst and ventricular cyst. So for non-calcified cysts and ventricular cysts. That means cysts in the ventricle. That's all. So they can also detect spinal cysticerci. So obviously not of the brain. You can do of the spinal cord also. Cysticerci. Okay. You can scan for non-calcified cyst and ventricular cyst and also for spinal cysticerci. Okay. So we are done with imaging now. Let's move on to serology. How many people sleeping? How many people awake? Shall we continue with the lab diagnosis of cysticercosis? Okay, right? So let us look at the serology, the antibody detection. Antibody detection, antigen detection, both they wrote in serology. Okay. Antibody detection. So here again you have ELISA. What else will they write? Always same thing. ELISA. Enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. So basically here you're going to detect the antibodies, that is the anti-cysticercus antibodies in serum and CSF. So you will detect antibodies in in the serum and in the CSF you can detect the antibodies. Okay. Now you can also use another technique, that is EITB, that is enzyme linked immunoelectrotransfer blot. What is EITB? EITB is enzyme linked immunoelectrotransfer. They didn't type correctly, or it is transfer spelling they have put correctly, incorrectly in the textbook. Immunoelectrotransfer blot. Okay, EITB. So antigen detection you can detect in serum and CSF again. So in serum and CSF, same thing, serology, detect in serum and CSF. So antigen detection you will do using ELISA, monoclonal antibodies. And it indicates recent infection. This indicates recent infection. If you find antigen, indicates recent infection. Okay. Others, ocular cysticercosis can be made out by ophthalmoscopy. So ocular cysticercosis, how you will detect? Ophthalmoscopy. Okay. So you can detect all these cysticerci in ophthalmoscopy. Eosinophilia, remember, eosinophilia can indicate early stage of cysticercosis, and also hookworm infestation usually, right? So it's not only this, but yeah, early stage of cysticercosis. Fine. Moving on, guys. How many people still interested in this video? Don't worry, we are almost at the end. Okay, we'll look at the treatment, that's all. Now only treatment and profile access is left. So let us move on now to the treatment. Treatment is praziquantel. This is praziquantel. Give it for what? Tinea, tapeworm. So 10 to 20 mg per kg is drug of choice, they are saying. I think this much is enough. Cannot remember all the names. Cysticercosis, for cysticercosis, excision is best method, they are saying. Okay. For neurocysticercosis, usually asymptomatic, obviously they won't give treatment now because they don't know it is there. But otherwise you can give anti-epileptic drugs. For anti-epileptic drugs you can give if there is neurocysticercosis. Okay. Let's not go into too much details about this. Prophylaxis. In meat, na, in the slaughterhouse, they should test it for cysticerci. Okay. Then, don't eat undercooked beef, don't eat undercooked pork, don't eat don't eat raw vegetables. Just make sure that you bring it heated to 56 degrees centigrade for 5 minutes. That's what they're saying. That's the thermal point. Not a high temperature. You can try to cook it, right? Then all this is community medicine stuff. Clean personal habit, great sanitary measures, disposal of sewage, prevention of fecal contamination of soil, all this stuff. Then you detect and treat people who are carrying these adult worms, okay? Because they will have asymptomatic situation, so they can have auto-infection. So that is the prophylaxis, guys. Hope you enjoyed the prophylaxis. Hope you enjoyed everything. Now let us move on to a complete review of what we have seen so far in this video. We started off with lab diagnosis, correct? So lab diagnosis, we started off with the lab diagnosis of intestinal teniasis, stool examination. So stool, first you will concentrate, then you will look for the eggs, then you look for proglottids, then you look for the scolex. You will detect the antigen. Serodiagnosis, ELISA, IFT, IHA, that is hemagglutination, right? IHA. Then IFT is indirect immunofluorescence test. Then you will detect the antibodies to the cysticercosis. Okay, then molecular diagnosis, PCR, DNA probes, you cannot differentiate. Okay, then moving on. Cysticercosis, cysticercosis lab diagnosis is very unique. It's not the same typical lab diagnosis of stool examination, all that. See here, it's biopsy of lesion, imaging, X-ray, CT, MRI, serology, you will do what? ELISA, same thing, EITB, antigen detection you can do. Then for ocular cysticercosis, you will use ophthalmoscope. Then you will, eosinophilia, you will detect in blood. So it's this cysticercosis lab diagnosis kind of different, it's kind of special. So, if you want, you can just look at the details of cysticercosis lab diagnosis some more, okay? Moving on, then we saw the treatment, praziquantel tapeworm, then prophylaxis. Okay, that's all for now. We finished off tinea. Tinea is over. Bye, tapeworm.